Yeah, that's loot for down, and loot once again. This guy is pinpoint accurate. What are you going to do? You can't move on this shoreline. You can't take a position because as soon as you do, footballist, just send bullets your way and there's no way you're not catching them. Playing back from Novo up to Zaki, footballists are going to be happy with this one. And this is a good start for footballers. Obviously, they really do need to get raring and good to go. Get those engines purring because... Speaking of breaching onto the northern shore there, footballists cross the bridge. They're looking for... What? I just had a little bit of an itch on my hand. I don't know what you're talking about. No, Bigatron are going to be guarding it, though. Footballist are going to meet heavy contestation here. Zuxi blinking away with a mini. Not quite able to land any damage there, Blank, but... At the moment, footballists have managed to send two people across. They're safe there, but they still have more to go. They have more ground to cover. That they do. Footballers just trying to leapfrog one another right now, and it seems to be working just a little bit, but they want to make all the way across. Zuxi taking some shots, but a nice little shot coming from Sol K, and we keep talking about this guy, and Max mentioned how, you know, he's the fragging power of the team. He gets forward onto them. Fantastic stuff to begin this off. Going forwards, Ryzen. Oh, takes down Lovazin. A little bit too aggressive there from footballers, but the rest of the team is there to back it up. Lutz, from up top, finds a frag onto Ryzen, flushes it down as well. One for one right now, and with Zuxi fallen, footballists have the advantage in the fight. That they do. Just looking forwards a little bit. Microroy's got a cheeky little angle where he can look over the top here. Quite going for it yet. Zuxi will get finished out. Great stuff from footballists, though. Being able to breach across this bridge takes a lot of skill on your side. We'll be able to get that second kill as well. Bigatron, as you say, they get taken down there as footballists manage to get themselves a little bit of an area on the south side of the circle. A1, though, out to the west of footballists might prove to be tricky. You've got a lot of teams, and now from that northwestern edge, this is where this is starting to come to a head, right? You've got Class Digital Athletics, Zeus, and RRQ all on Sharkfin out to the west. And they're all going to have to push in a little bit further.
They will. I mean, A1, they're pretty desperate at this point. I'm not going to lie to you, John. They're trying to make it happen as best they can. But I'm looking over to this western side. RRQ, Digital Athletics, Zeus, they're all crunching up here. They'll have to come through that snaking road. But most teams just trying to find a position to stay.
Bigatron and footballers continue to clash. They know Luxy's up there. Oh, a beautiful nade set up by footballist, but he knows where they are. Lux crossing the field. Not quite able to get that one over the lip there as Luxy continues to be on that island up there. Another nade bobbles over the top, but Luxy finds some cover, Blank, and he's now just high and dry right now. Unfortunate for him. On the exit to the bridge, they tried to guard out footballist, but they found out just what this team can do. Another nade up top, but again, not quite finding that final damage.
No, I mean, this is a really hard position for footballist here, but what a nade! Swings over the top, and footballist take down Bigatron. Footballists, look, this is a great start. I mentioned it right at the beginning of the cast. I want to see them have a good start to this. I don't think we've seen Team Secret Gin get a big win as of yet. This could be the moment, like you're saying, John, to make it happen on the coastal side. They managed to slip by unattacked as well, so just great stuff.
Ron there hits the deck, tries to escape the pressure from Gonzo and the rest of Kanina Power as well. Has to reload the M4 before he gets the next spray on. That was unfortunate, you're right. I mean, he sprayed down Rorm earlier, so was looking for that trade. Soulcake, able to back up his team, but Axa sends out onto the beach, sends onto the ridgeline, picks his mate up in the car, and they're on their way. Lutz suppressing. And footballist actually managed to get away by the skin of their teeth.
Yeah, beautiful stuff from Lutz there to be able to give that suppressing fire on the top side just to calm Kanina Power down for the time being, you know? Just bring it back down to a nice, peaceful level.
Call them the Horse Whisperer.
Exactly. Power Triple Eight, they've got a 2-2 split, but you imagine that at this point they would love to regroup one another.
Oh.
Nice knock there from Round with the DP from range.
It is just pressure, though. It's preventing any further movements for the time being because they aren't going to be able to run this down, right? They're not going to be looking to leave this compound anytime soon.
Typically as well, in Battle Royales, especially here in PUBG Mobile,
it is good to be this team. Like, you're almost like a feral creature, and you're just letting teams know that we are here. You don't push us. We will knock you if you come close. You know, if you're too passive, if you don't take any fights, then teams might consider pushing you. But for now, Power 888 realizes that actually there's a pretty hefty team in this compound, and it might be unwise for us to go down here. So Footballists, they've secured this position on the coastal side. Now they've got to really hope against hope that the circle heads towards them, because leaving this beachside is going to be gross, as they found out before trying to pass Kanina Power.
Oi, stops. I see you up there. I see you up there. You thinking about coming anywhere near us? Stop it. Stop that right now. Get those ideas out your head. I'll shoot thee. Can't happen. Not going to happen. On the western side, though, might just happen. Kanina Power and RRQ now starting to get a little bit closer on these rotations. And with that hard stop of Footballist, it's going to be pretty tricky. But then look at this northeastern cluster around Milter, yeah, and Mini Milter as well. Milter Power, sorry, and Mini Milter out to the west side of it. There's about four teams in this area on the eastern side. But Rom finally does go down. It stops to play spoiler to the suppression of Footballist.
Oh, yeah, I mean,
try and guard. Oh, look at the
shit. Peek your head out for too long. What is going on in this game?
Oh, my goodness.
That is more. That's almost more water than there's land in this situation here. That is disgusting. But loops. What a rotation from them, finding a perfect position within this circle.
Throwing the lasso around, and we'll be keeping it under control.
Yeah, the white chalk telling people exactly where they cannot cross.
Lines of salt, maybe? We'll have to wait and see. But Footballist, still in their compound, will have to move and move out to the east now. The shots start to pop off, and it's Kanina Power as well with a bit of oversight. Loops take a knock over towards Nova XQF, but Footballist, they're still in it just for now with two players. Rorm and Soulcate still going.
Count Cosmos putting in the work, but it's Kanina Power start to sweep in from the side here, edging their way around, trying to find a better position. Oh, or let's see what happens.
Plane path all the way on the western side, north to south there, and manages to hold it down. Who'd have thunk it? Who'd have thunk it? Secret Gin from riches to rags this time around. Chicken dinner to going down in 15th place.
Look, man, Kengzo too used to playing solo. He wasn't even in that fight for quite a while. By the time he got there, it was way too late.
There were some pretty important parts of that fight, and I have to say, Corpi getting those two knocks, not likely, not a likely situation either way. And the rock up, the double knock on the roll up from the backup of Power 888.
That's a telestration I'd like to see.
Maybe. If we're lucky, if we've been good, maybe for Christmas, they'll give us that telestration on the desk. But we'll have to wait and see. Maybe they've got something more important to talk about.
This is a very important fight, though, coming on the screen. It's that control of castle. A lot of teams know it's a really good spot. How has he hit that shot? Soulcate as well, just doing Soulcate stuff.
It's because he's really good. That's how he
really
hit that shot.
Really fantastic.
And this is the split, actually, from Nova XQF. They left two in Castle, and Coolboy and Jimmy are actually all the way out towards Cement Factory. There's no way they could have come in for backup on this fight.
Yeah, you know, when you do a 2-2 split like that, usually what you want to do is be able to be in range. And I think if anything we can take away from this map already is that you need to be prepared and ready to regroup with your team at a moment's notice. So now Nova XQF, now it's just two players. We saw what they could do with two players last game, but, you know, this time it's Jimmy and Coolboy on their own.
All alone. So no one here beside them.
Poor Power Boy.
Footballist just trying to pick up that kill. And
Regiosio drops himself inwards, trying to throw grenades through the windows, but he's taking shots of himself. That's from loot, what?
Okay, long range for the castle. The battlements providing ample vision there for the squad. Has to drop the smoke to get the res here. Aita-chan.
Cliffside, knowing, trusting his teammates to stay alive. Cheeky little spot there from Footballist. But, yeah, that was pretty much done-zoed as soon as they got the first knock on the first floor. Abelie was desperately trying to control that. After that happens, nades can come on the top side.
Turning them into mincemeat right now as Luxy gets flushed out. Zuxi there, Federal sends out. We'll draw up the spray. And I got a minute.
Yeah,
it was Footballist to get that final kill. Either way, Bigatron eliminated. But not before A1 go down.
Oh, yes. So good from there. I mean, you may as well use the battlements to your advantage. I mean, they're designed so you can shoot out of them, and they're not. It's very hard for you to get shot back at because it's just tiny slits in the wall. Luz Federal here with the M24 in hand. See what we can do with that.
He managed to get a knock onto Bigatron with it. Okay, Golden tries to go over a ridge line, but thinks better of it. Karofsky's downed as well. But this is a castle circle. This is the power of having castles position in this sort of circle. No one quite managing to get onto it just yet to challenge that position. But four angry men have an outpost there. Power Triple Eight waiting on that bridge to try and cross.
Yeah, I mean, Football is currently around about 420 damage ahead of everyone else, so they're doing fantastically well inside a castle. And you kind of, it's a massive gamble going to castle. You know that Nova XQF is definitely kicking themselves right now for not holding onto it as strongly as they could have done with that split they had on castle itself. Footballers instantly knew. They were like, look, it looks like this is central. Let's just take it. Even if we don't get the circle itself, we can get some good kill points on board. Currently, they're at 6, so they're the highest in the lobby right now, so certainly working out in their favor.
The circle comes in, and a lot of castles still in it, Blank. Footballist from the Ramparts. No one really on that south side, which is actually a blessing for Footballists, given how the circle has shifted here. It means they can put most of their attention towards that northern edge, but they know that Loops is still under that bridge. Blue Bees now crashing into Kanina Power, and actually Footballists still just keeping the suppressing fire in every single direction. Blue Bees have had no luck on these crashes, with Footballists looking over every single one of them.
Yeah, that's Lufa down, and Loots once again. This guy is pinpoint accurate.
What are you going to do? You can't move on this shoreline. You can't take a position, because as soon as you do, Footballist just send bullets your way, and there's no way you're not catching them.
I mean, Loots, let me just put this in perspective for you, John. I mean, let's quickly pull up the damage. I mean, he's 930 damage for Footballist right now. Footballist currently have a total of 1,500. So he is doing absolute work for this team. He is the sledgehammer. It's incredible.
Looking to try and breach the compound, though. Loops have managed to get their way up to the cliff face, and this could be pretty tricky now for Footballists to try and hold off. They've had oversight for quite a while, but now they're going to have to be worried about those lowly rats trying to crawl in through the sewers. Yeah. But Loops looking pretty mighty themselves. However, they've got people to worry about on the opposite shore.
I mean, looking at this, obviously Rodini just trying to make his way in, gets a flush, gets a kill point. That's nice. Idachan just cooking their grenade, but there's Loots. There's Loots once again, doing Loots things. What you got to look at here with this circle, you can see it on the right side of your screen at the moment, is that the scary thing about castle is that there's three entrances to it. If anything, this circle not always being on top of castle only proves to improve their position, because they cannot get pushed from the southwestern bridge. They can't get pushed from the southeastern bridge either. All they can get pushed by is by the northwest bridge, which they have firm control over, currently still with four players. You could pretty much say that Footballists right now, they have this game in the bag.
As Nova XQF, the remaining player from them, Jimmy, to try and make something happen on that edge as the circle shifts out north as well. They might want to think about repositioning here, but no, they want the fight. Solkay over the top of the micro Uzi. Golden slips down immediately, falls. Carrillo all the way off of the wings as Federal falls to boot, and now two players from Loops getting flushed out. Easy stuff for Loops, and 9 kills now for Footballists.
This is probably one of the most dominant games I've seen from a single player in probably the entirety of the PMGC coming out from Loots. This guy has been on absolute fire. Pretty much the rest of the team's just swimming, though. Footballers with 4. It's going to be very, very hard to demount them.
Ooh, goodness me. RRQ now start to get knocked from across the way. Up in Lutz Tower, he's just...
How do you like that?
Swinging on down. Trying to take everybody who tries to dare cross away, but Power Triple Eight are going to be eliminated as well in the midst of things, and 4 angry men now actually providing a buffer for Footballist on the northern side. It will be very difficult for them to deal with it later on. However, RRQ very low, just G9 remain. Footballist try and swing out low. They want to go under the bridge, giving up the position up in Lutz Towers. And they are going to have to roll on down, see if they can deal with 4 angry men who are currently guarding against Alpha 7 on the cross as well. Rorm just giving information on where anyone is in the water. Beautiful stuff. They know that they have a dominant spot.
This is going to be a huge amount of kills coming through on the Footballists. They have 2 more to confirm in the water as well. 13, make that probably 15 at this point. Footballists having a massive game here. 2,750 in terms of damage. Closest behind them is 1,436 in 4 angry men. I would say probably the top two here, RQ and Loops, are just trying to hold on. But really the fight is between Footballists and 4AM. But Solkay is just a nutter.
Solkay sinks one, but not quite able to get the knock just yet. Sook and Svan now have a massive amount of pressure on them. How far can Loops go? How far can RRQ survive? That's the question for me.
And how much utility does 4AM have left in the back? Once they leave that position, they're going to be in a really rough spot. Football is still with four players alive. It's a 2v4 here, and 4AM have to squeeze their way around this coastal site. You'll imagine that footballists will have taken a lot of fights, but look at this realm. Wow. Three first aid kits still on board. It is just happening right now for this team.
That was 2 points worth of survival there for RRQ as well. You have to remember, laddering up from 8 to 10.
This has to be a great nade.
This does have to be a phenomenal nade. Probably the best nade we've ever seen, but it doesn't do any damage and will not be able to hold off Solke. Up the top, he goes around the side of the tree, doesn't spot the guy behind it, but Souk is going to fall down. No, no, he's not. Solke is in a bit of a risky spot here. Svan tries to hold it down, but it was only going to be so long before they take it down. It's footballist to dominate. The castle is theirs. They are the kings of Vikendi. The foreseeable future will be jam-packed with plenty of PUBG Mobile blank. We're going to be getting into it. The plane path on the eastern side of the map.
We're looking at the 9-minute mark to finish and still 46 players alive. So it's going to be a jam-packed 10 minutes ahead of us. So let's get ready for it, John. Now the nades coming over the top. Football is trying to take Alpha 7's position. Beautiful beginning. That's Solke once again. This guy really gets the fights going for this team. He is the spearhead.
They're riding high right now from the previous game, and they will get Sagan as well. Law last now standing as Senatexa falls up on the top of the hill. Very isolated from the rest of the squad. Senatexa, there's no way they're getting that back up, and he might just have to run straight back towards Bigitron. This is a very unfortunate position for Law, where Alpha 7 find themselves.
Just with a couple of players on board, but utility, it's looking low, John.
It's looking pretty shaky. Two duos on the map at the moment, Nova XQF and A1, but 2 4-player squads looking to try and clash over the hilltop here, over the side of this mountainous terrain. But Bigitron, they take first knock, and it's Rom to find Zuxi. Low HP as well on Micro Boy. Nades are starting to fly, and this is a really good start to the fight for Footballist.
This could be a good moment for Nova XQF as well.
Oh, nades.
Just to kind of do a little bit of damage onto both
teams,
but Footballist, the nades over and over. Bigatron can't handle it.
Blowing the horn of Gondor right now, and the backup comes through. The bombardment is in. Trebuchets are flying, and it's Footballist who are going to hold strong right now. They make their way into the circle. They're not overstaying. They're welcome, but Bigitron, they're allowed to get these reses now.
Any way they can make the ensuing fight easier is perfect. Solke takes a fair bit of damage. There's Ryza, but it's immediately dropped back onto him.
One for one right now between these 2 4-man squads. Nova XQF still with their duo, still trying to get anything they can, and they take the north side. That'll be good for them, as no one's going to be able to push all the way over. They might just be able to ladder up a little bit further. Dante holds it down though, as Lux spots it, and will be able to get the spray as Zuxi falls, but that's so many players going down left to right. Ruts, Rom and Lutz both alive. Luxy last standing now for Bigatron as players start to fall, and Nova XQF, they're still alive. Preparing, biding their time. The zone will shift and it goes southeast. Nova XQF will have to move, but will it happen before this fight pops off? Solke goes out wide. Luxy steps up, will go down. Traded one for one. Rom able to land those shots. Solke the only player down, and it's Ryzen the only player up for Bigatron. Footballist will get this res. They want to play it by the book.
Ryzen just crawling his way in. This guy has been MVP more times than I can count, and he certainly has the chops on him to go for a big clutch here. But how many fights a footballer has taken? You see Lovazin, no first aid kits remaining, and Ryzen just drops into the bush side. Lovazin just jumping over the top. This team is so down on meds.
Cool boy though, look at the position he's managed to take. He's popping a nade. He knows where footballists are. All of this gunfire has made plenty of noise. If it lands in the right place, that could be disaster for footballist.
This one seems on track.
Able to get it up, but Coolboy will be spotted there. Rom spots him as he lobs that nade over the sidelines. Ryzen, I think he wants to just try and wait this fight out, but I don't know how much longer he can go. 11 points found for Bigatron already on the gain. They want to see if they can ladder up, get some more. Coolboy goes down, goes low. Solke is there.
Yes, you must see him.
What are you doing? Nova XQF, they get eliminated. Ryzen now, he's in the bush. One down, Lutz soon to follow. Ryzen in the bush, looking to pop up. Will he find it?
Are you kidding me?
Oh my God, it's Bigatron. Ryzen, how do you make that happen?
They get a gap. Here we go into match number 4, and there's gonna be a lot of space on this map because we're at Sandhawk, baby, and Digital Athletics opted to take a swim here at Sandhawk.
Look at the aqua rail. Only two people can get on it, so it would have been funny if we saw one of them pop on over there. That might have been the play. Yes, it takes a couple seconds to actually get onto it, but it would be a lot quicker to have that jet ski versus swimming right now, especially with Soul K, you know, aiming right on top of you.
Oh yeah, forget that. There, you know, there's no way they want to even touch a boat right now because they are just getting focused on hard. Oh, Salim actually ends up getting caught by Soul K as well. Soul K going fishing, busting out the rod and catching one. And he's looking for a couple more. I mean, so far, football has two kills early on, but they just do not want anybody swimming across this river for free.
DA, they're honestly the fish of this lobby. I mean, every game there's water, DA, they're in it. At least when we look at their games today. Very interesting to see that coming into play.
Power Triple Eight, they are just
threaded.
Yeah, just open for the pickings on all these squads. They're in a really tough spot in this circle.
Yeah, this hurts. I mean, this position always hurts to watch. When a team is forced to run up this large hill, there is no cover, nothing at all. It just comes down to hitting your shots and being able to recognize exactly where you're getting shot from. Looks like they're going to be pinched down for the time being up there to the north. And 4 a.m., they heard the shots. They were thinking about heading in this direction. They said, nah, we ain't going there. We're gonna wide rotate all the way around Camp Alpha. But the cliffs, heading back to cliffs. Footballists and Execute, they have been up in these cliffs since circle number one. Now both teams, they need to push on out of here.
Yeah, you know that they were just hoping to stay right where they were at this and for the rest of the game. But with this southern shift, they're going to have to start heading their way down. And you can just see they're trying to figure out what's the best position to do so, because you got footballists on the side of them, Power 8 coming up on top, and Secret Gin ready to gatekeep it here as well. Look at the circle. This is just going to be absolute chaos right now.
I need a power. They could chill on the coastline, on the shoreline, but they are going to be sandwiched by Nova and BTR. Just unlucky. Looking at Execute, here comes the blue zone. Now we'll be applying some pressure to these teams in the north.
Even Zute just trying to send it on a moped, unable to make the rotation though. And you can just see Kill Switch getting a good couple of knocks on the footballist right here. It's only Lobazin left, and he is getting damaged by the blue zone tremendously as this circle starts heading even further south away from these squads. And Kill Switch, yeah, at this point, he's stuck to heal duty. And I don't know how long it's going to last for. Oh, gets confirmed. And you know that's going to open up a lot of real estate for them.
And that hill that they are currently prone on is huge. It provides the cover. Lobazin from footballers, we saw there in the player cam, disappointed to get taken out. We also saw about 10 players get taken out. Players loaded on up, Hot Jukes. Let's get on in to the last match of today.
What?
Just like that. And footballers cruising. They know exactly who they are behind. All you have to do is watch the VODs a couple times to get a general idea that Bigatron, they like to hover around this area when these zones do favor them.
I love this from footballists though. You see how they didn't just send it on in with those vehicles. They stopped right at that coastline, started to scout it out, and are moving up little by little. Looks like Rom is going to get the eyes onto Bigatron and take a couple pop shots at him. Only thing though is I don't know if that was the best decision, because now all eyes are on them from this rotation spot. We'll see if that ends up paying off though.
I mean, Bigatron, they're setting up in this three-story. We saw Microboy with the four times SKS. Like, they're also kind of banking on the fact that there will be a rotate down there to the south. So I think football is taking some shots. It's like, okay, don't mess with us. Let's just be. And we see them passing them right by.
Oh yeah, they're gonna go ahead and get this rotate on away. Gotta be really careful though, because they're gonna be going into quite a few squads. Opt to take the shack right here. This is a good position. And I think they're gonna probably stop here, possibly scout little by little. Soul K possibly just driving around trying to do exactly that. And it looks like Jimmy is gonna be driving right by football as Lobazin's looking straight at him. Oh, not able to get the good position to get those shots off though. And Jimmy, after those, he's gonna be driving on up. Look at this, Digital Athletics coming on that way, but Lobazin with the laser beam. He's gonna pop him out right there. And then now we got Nova XQF down to a duo.
They got their team up. Soul K really doesn't want to give up. Just Dacia missing a tire.
Yeah, I'll tell you what though, RRQ, they're on top of Potato Hill. This is their land. They love this position. and they might just get some extra love from Lavazin as he's gonna drive right on into them. There's the two-piece. You cannot drive on a potato hill like this for free. You gotta know RRQ is waiting for you. And just like that, footballist, free 2 points. Ice water in his veins. Like, this is just another day in the office. That's what you love to see right there. This Blue Bee squad never fail. They're gonna have to be able to make some plays. Gotta play this real carefully, especially when you're so split. Zute, he felt those ones. And let's see how long they're gonna be able to hold on for.